the fireworks still over for that boat.
It's hard to believe it's been 2 years. I mean, we went from not hearing her babbling at all to singing us the days of the week. Her progress has been amazing. That her growth has been tremendous. She's learning right there with her peers.
Lately, she's really been able to advocate for herself as far as, are CIs working, are they not? Which one is working, are they off?
I can get my shoes down.
Okay.
Chloe loves her sister, so if her sister's around, she's gonna be next to her. So I don't think either one of them see a difference between the two of them.
She leads Sydney's 4-H calf around, and she got stepped on once, but she got back up, and she's tough. She goes and checks cows with me on the four-wheeler. There's nothing we wish she could do that she can't do.
What should I do next? Chloe likes to be in the kitchen. She enjoys helping and sampling. Sometimes it's a little too much help. We end up with flour and sugar where it doesn't need to be.
I tried.
You did try very hard. Things are normal. Things are going great for her, but there are a lot of things going on for her behind the scenes. You know, she gets seen 3 times a week by 3 different individuals. So she works hard at it just as much as we say it's normal, but she is working hard at it. She wants to learn.
The fireworks still over that week.
We're working with her on age-appropriate sounds, developmental sounds, you know, the K sound, the S sound, the F sound, the G sound. So developmentally, she's where she needs to be. We go to Boys Town twice a year, every 6 months, or unless needed. I've always said that her right ear is her dominant ear, it's her first ear. So they were really trying to work on getting that left ear to kind of boost it up to give her better overall hearing. And that's what's great about Boys Town. She's doing great. I mean, she's doing above her normal age peers, but yet they said, well, let's see what we can do to make it better.
What are you going to do when you turn 3?
Go to preschool.
You get to go to preschool? That'll be fun. What do you do at preschool?
Listen.
You listen? Yeah. Do you think you get to play?
And that was, I guess, one goal of ours was to make sure she gets in. It'll be a good, tough environment for her to learn in, and it'll be challenging for her, and so we're really hopeful that she'll do well.
I gotta get over the ins and outs and ups and downs of her, you know, not just my baby going, but, you know, of her learning and thriving with other peers in a different setting is gonna be different. It's gonna be challenging for her, but she's ready. Is just getting her mom ready too. It's hard to believe, really. There are days that I probably can say that I don't realize that she is a child with bilateral profound hearing loss. To me, it seems no different than raising her older sister. You know, there are times that you have to remember, you know, like going down the slide, we have to make sure there's static guard on it. Or if it's raining, she needs to cover her CI so they don't get wet. So there's moments like that that you're like, okay, we need to do this. But for the most part, she's a typical 3-year-old child running around our house.
We're fortunate to be able to have got to this point, without a doubt. And that's a credit to her and everybody that's helped her get there.
Thank you, Boy Town.